All right. Next one. How is life different when you trust people versus not trusting people? How is your life different when you trust people versus not trust people? Okay. When you don't trust people, you can't relax. So that pretty much affects everything in your life. When you can't trust people, you don't ask for help. So you always feel lonely, isolated. And it's actually kind of like, even though some of us have a lot of trust issues, and I've certainly had massive trust issues, I've had to actually work through this. My base level trust was shattered when I was a child several times by different people. So I literally trusted nobody. And that's why I became, a workaholic and all those kinds of things. But what happens when you don't trust people? Your life experience becomes all about trying to make people see that you have value. Because you're, on one hand, you can't trust anybody to ask them for help. But then on the other hand, you have to be really competent all the time because you can't ask for help. So it enters you into this cycle, which is really bad for you and very isolating. And so when you do trust people, you can trust people, like you don't just trust people explicitly because everybody has different agendas, everybody has different, goals in life, different values. So you don't just like trust everybody with everything that you have. But what you can do is you can trust people to be exactly who they are, which is fantastic. People will always be exactly who they are, and people will always live according to their values. So if you think that trust is something that, is defined by how well people are living up to your values, then you won't ever trust other people because nobody lives up to your values. Okay? So when you do accept and trust that people live up to their values, now you can start interesting conversations with them. You can ask them questions about their values. Hey, what's important to you? How would you do this thing? What would your, I'm in this situation. What would you do in this situation? What would your approach be? And you learn a lot more because now you're no longer on guard all the time. You're actually asking people for their different perspectives, their different value, kind of expressions of value, and so on. So when you begin to trust that people will live up to their values, and then you start deliberately surrounding yourself with people who have good values, not necessarily same values as you do, but value like something like that they're not trying to make you be who you're not. So when you can find people who want to support you to be who you are, then what happens is that you can start trusting people a lot more with your values too. So it's a process, and it can take a lot of time. It took me years to get to a point where now I feel like nobody's out to get me, which is very, very long way from where I used to be.